roads, boosting connection and communication throughout the world.
In China's East, there is a road called 古蜀道. It has existed for thousands of years, even before the Roman Bridge. It also has a name called the Ancient Roadway Transition Fossil. Today, Xiao Qiao will take you to explore the 古蜀道.
According to the ancient records, the construction of the road can be traced as far back as the Western Zhou Dynasty. Today, if people want to enjoy a good view of this ancient relic of transportation, the nearly 300 km long Guangyuan section of the ancient ShuDao is the best choice. This section is the best preserved and possesses the most significant cultural elements. There are more than 130 related cultural heritage sites along the road.
Wow, 现在我们都已经来到翠云廊了，脚底下是青石板路，两旁是高高大大的柏树，行走在这里边啊，真的是太舒服，太惬意了。胡老师，我们现在走的这条路啊，听说叫做古蜀道，
对，
为什么会被称作为古蜀道呢？您来给我们简单的讲解一下。
古蜀道呢，是指中国古代从关中平原十三朝古都长安翻秦岭，穿越大巴山。
到达四川盆地的交通大动脉，北边有子午道、趟驴道、包斜道、陈仓道，南边主要有金牛道、李仓道、荔枝道。看，这棵就是帅大柏了，它呢是翠云廊大柏树湾当中最大的一棵，至少要5个人才能合抱。 它都是有声音、有感觉、感知的。我们现在走的这段路呢，相当于古时候的公路。这条路呢，叫做拦马墙，这边有很多堆砌起来的石块，那它的作用呢，就是为了防止马匹在运输货物的过程当中意外跌落至山崖，所以将它形成了安全的保护屏障，也就是现在公路上的安全护栏。 这条古老而又神奇的道路，怎么样才能让更多人知道呢？于是，咱们广元首批推出了3条古蜀道徒步游线路。Walking
on the ancient ShuDao, you can travel through history and feel the changes from past to present. Looking at the roads, passes, and ancient gate passes built in ancient times, and appreciating the ancient cypress trees that have survived to this day. You can walk in the very footsteps of the ancients, injecting vitality into the ancient ShuDao with your strength.